Welcome back. As your kids are getting ready to go back to school, they may be feeling anxious. In fact, anxiety disorder among kids is on the rise. So how can parents help their children ease back into the new school year with less stress? Let's go ahead and talk about it. Author and mindfulness expert Julie Potiker joins us this morning. Good morning to you. Thank you so much for being here with us. What is causing all of this anxiety?
Oh, that's a big, huge question.
I know. I want to know. I was just saying, as a parent, you never stop worrying about your kids. First, you know, they're babies, and you're like, oh, what's going on with them? They can't fall asleep because their tummy hurts, whatever. Now we're worried about anxiety.
So I think that life is causing this anxiety, and the better question is, what are we going to do about it?
Okay.
So I brought a whole bunch of tips to help ease your kid, depending on their age, into the school year.
We'll talk a little bit about some of the things. Like, I read some of the stuff that you sent us. You're talking about, like, social media and just, you know, obviously school in general.
School in general. So the first thing that I think it's helpful to do to talk to your kids about is their feelings and their emotions. Mm-hmm. So we know as adults, if we name our emotions, it calms our system down.
Right.
And I think we've talked about this
before. Right, acknowledging that.
Right, like, I'm feeling anger coming up. I'm feeling sadness or anxiety.
Yeah.
If you recognize the acronyms RAIN, you're recognize you have that emotion, you allow it to be there, so you're not just stuffing it down, because what you resist persists, and what you can feel, you can heal.
Right? Good, that's good. That's a good point.
You investigate why it's there. Sure, I'm nervous. Everybody's nervous right before school, right? And then you nourish yourself by telling yourself what you need to hear. I can do this, it's gonna be fine. But there's other tips that as parents we can help our kids ease through the beginning of the school year, like visit the school.
With them.
With them.
Okay.
You know, a lot of schools have back to school nights, some don't. Some parents are too busy and they miss them.
Make an effort.
Make an effort to walk that campus with the kid, go down the halls, go into the classroom if you can.
But even if it's not their first year at
even
the school,
even if it's not their first
back
year,
to school.
Okay.
Well, let's
go
talk
school shopping with them for their backpack.
Okay.
Right.
Oh, and then have that conversation.
Have
with
that
them.
Conversation. Let them pick. I want the blue binder to be for English, and I want the spiral notebook red to be for math or whatever it is, so that they have more control over it.
How do you know your child is having anxiety? Is that when you go to the store with them, you have that little conversation, and then you kind of pick up on it?
So it depends on the kid, but kids usually act out.
Okay.
So it's feeling a difficult emotion, and then it looks like anxiety. So maybe it's vulnerability, maybe it's embarrassment, maybe it's sadness, but something's going on there that they don't feel like they can manage or regulate, and so then they act out in some way.
Gotcha. Right? Okay, so you said go shopping with them. What other things can you do?
There's all kinds of books.
Okay.
I hit the bookstore in my own personal collection before this.
Here it is. Here's one.
And when I went to Warwick's, there's great little kid books that you can talk about school jitters with.
How little?
That's, I'd say, kindergarten, first, second, and third grade.
Okay.
It would be very cute.
Do you think my three-year-old has anxiety going back to school? She has no idea.
She might be afraid
I don't
to
know.
Leave you. She might have separation anxiety.
Well, she does in a way, but then she's really happy about
Absolutely.
It. But I was just wondering
Michael used to, we used to have to pull his fingers off of me when he was that age. Yeah, and then I would peek in the window and I'd see him coloring and happy.
Yeah, exactly.
And I'd be like,
that's how,
that kid did that just to get me. No, if you've got kids that are older, and they read Dan Siegel's work on the teenage brain, which really goes all the way up into your 20s, when they realize that they can have control over what they think, which means they'll end up with control over what they feel, that's very empowering for them. Also,
your book.
Parents need to manage their own stuff.
Right, we talked
so
about this.
My book has a lot of tips and tricks, as does the Mindful Self-Compassion workbook. I think that kids should gratitude journal. And if they're really little, like your kid's age, they can make a gratitude jar as a craft project.
Oh, that's a good idea.
With gooey, sticky things on it. And then they can tell you what they're grateful for every day, and you can pop it in that jar.
That is
and
awesome.
And that will help them all year long and all lifelong.
That's, that's
you know.
Absolutely true.
And there's a journal for journaling.
That's the one I have. You know, I will tell you, this is a great conversation. Thank you so much for being here with us. I think as the kids are heading back to school, they're anxious about going, you know, they're having anxiety, but the parents, they're happy. they're happy the kids are going back to school because they were dealing with anxiety because they couldn't figure out what to do with the kids.
Feel this.
Oh, yes. This will really help you.
So if you're too young to understand how to focus on a stone.
Ah.
Ta-da.
Okay. Well, I learned a lot this morning. Thank you so much, Julie, for being here with us. I'll take these two. Netta, you might need one of these as well.
Can you throw that over here?
Oh, good catch.
Good catch. There we go.
Thank you, ladies.